trust that you are all blessed and well. Better is one day in the presence of God than a thousand elsewhere. Amen. Today I'll be reading the Chronicle by Pastor Roshan Singh. It says, "We are his body. I pray that they will all be one, and you and I, just as you and I are one. As you are in me, Father, and I am in you. And may they be in us so that the world will believe you sent me. We are his body, and we have the world to win. We need all the help we can get. Therefore, as Christians, we must acknowledge each other and join together." Ephesians 4 verse 13 says that when we all unify in our faith, we will have the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. When Christians come together and begin to function as one body, we will have the Holy Spirit without measure, just like Jesus did. We must promote unity in the body of Christ. Amen. Begin to pray for others. Make a daily effort to pray for others, especially your leaders and missionaries out in the mission fields. Pray for your friends, your pastor, your parents, your teacher, and your brother and sister, and whomever the Lord may bring to your heart and mind. Once we truly join together in faith, all the demons of hell will not be able to resist the work of the kingdom. Even in our local church, there are so many people with diverse backgrounds and personalities. However, we must look at our local church as a large family. We are certainly to love each other and have good relationships, walking in respect and honor with each other. The Declaration of Faith says, "I decide to walk in unity of faith with all other believers today, especially in the household of faith. In Jesus' name, amen." I trust that you were all blessed with the Chronicle reading today, beloved. Let us get ready and be prepared to receive the Word of God from our pastor. Thank you.
Well, bless the Lord. Praise God, everybody. Welcome to our broadcast this morning. We are truly honored and privileged to have you join us this morning for our program. And I trust and I believe that you'll be blessed today. And I truly hope you've had a blessed week. Amen. Now, before we go into the Word of God, I'd like us to open, as usual, in a word of prayer. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank you, O Lord God, for the blessed opportunity to, Lord God, to share your word. We thank you, Lord, O God, for your precious word, for the preaching, the teaching, and the inspiration of your word. We thank you, O Lord God, for the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that you will teach us, lead us, and guide us in all truth. Thank you, my God, that this morning that faith will come by the hearing of the precious word of God. I pray for everybody that is under the influence of this broadcast this morning, O God. I pray, Lord, O God, that, Lord, they will receive, O Lord God, faith to help them. Whatever they are facing, O God, I thank you in the name of Jesus. By reason of your word, they will overcome in Jesus' blessed name. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you'll bless and anoint my vocal cords to speak your word to your people. We ask this in Jesus' precious name. God's people said, amen, 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 and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Now, I want to talk to you on the subject this morning of you being a word from God. That is, you are a word from God. If someone were to ask you, perhaps I could pose a question to you, what would a dog give birth to? Your answer would be obviously a dog. And if I asked you, what would a cat give birth to? You would tell me, obviously a cat. Now, I want to share something in 1 Peter chapter number 1, that you are a word from God. So if somebody were to ask you, who are you or what are you? You could boldly say, I am a word from God. Praise God. You are a word from God. Amen. So your life on earth, friend, it is not a mistake. It is not perchance. It is something that has been designed of God. It is God designed. It is God ordained and God planned and God purposed. Praise God. There's a purpose to your life and there's a purpose to you living. And I will share that with you this morning. Amen. In God's precious word. Now, the book of 1 Peter chapter number 1, I'm going to use that as a foundation to kick off. And we're going to start in verse 22. We read verses 22 and 23. Since you have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit in sincere love of the brethren, love one another fervently with a pure heart, having been born again, not of corruptible seed, but incorruptible through the Word of God, which lives and abides forever. Praise God. I want to read that again to you. Verse 23 says, having been born again, not of corruptible seed, but incorruptible through the word of God. Verse 22 speaks about loving the brethren, loving one another with a pure heart. Love is sincere, it is pure, praise God. And that is, the word of God is pure. The word of God is sincere. Hallelujah. Amen. The Bible tells us we should desire the sincere milk of the word of God, meaning that God's word is sincere, praise God. So we need to walk in sincerity in our love for the brethren and love for people. And we read here, we are born again, not of corruptible seed, but incorruptible by the word of God, which lives and abides forever. We've been born again, friends, by the gospel of Jesus Christ, the message of the gospel. That is God's word for humanity. Amen. Is that all men might be saved through Christ Jesus. That is the word of God. And that is a word that God has been speaking all these years. He said it yesterday. He's saying it today. And he'll say it tomorrow. God desires that all men be saved in Christ Jesus. And you and I are products of the word of God. I just asked you earlier on, if you were asked what would a dog give birth to, obviously you would say a dog. So the Bible says here, we are born again by the word of God. So if you are born of the word, what does that make you? That makes you word. So you are a word for your generation. You are a word for your nation. In the book of the Gospel of John, chapter number 1, and I want to read verses from verses 11 through to verse 13. The Bible speaking of Jesus, the Word of God, he says, Jesus, he came to his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. You were born of God. It was God's will that you be born. It was God's purpose that you be born. Hallelujah. And so, having heard the message of the gospel, you've now been born again. You have the life of God in you. The book of Galatians tells us, if we are Christ's, then are we Abraham's seed, referring to us as the seed of Christ. Hallelujah. And the Bible also tells us that the word of God is seed. That means you and I are seed. The amazing thing about a seed is that it contains within itself everything it needs to grow. And in order for the seed to grow, what you need to do, you need to sow it, you need to plant it. Hallelujah. Praise God. And that is you and I now, friends. We have been planted in this world. God has put us in this world so that we can grow and so that we can increase, amen, in the knowledge of God and Jesus Christ, his Son. Hallelujah. It is so that we can increase. God, you are now God's letter to humanity. You are God's letter to your generation. God's love letter. The gospel is the power of God's love and mercy. That's the message of the gospel. The love of God and the mercy of God. The goodness of God. The grace of God. Hallelujah. That's the message of the gospel. And you and I are products of the gospel. That means you and I now are carriers of the gospel. We have this treasure in earthen vessels that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of man. Praise God. We are word. You are a word from God. If somebody asks you, who are you? What are you? Tell me, who are you? What are you? You can say, I am a word from God. And I will share later on a little bit more about how powerful that statement is, being a word from God. And that is why it's so important that you spend time with the Word of God, because you are a seed and you have been planted for a purpose and for a time such as now. And it's so important that you take the Word of God and you start sowing it in your heart, so that the Word will be within you. And when the Word is within you, it will cause you to expand and grow, and you will increase in the things of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. So the Bible says, as many as received Christ, to them gave he the right to become children of God, who were born of the will of God. So if anybody has ever told you that you were born by mistake, or you were perhaps unplanned, I'm here to tell you this morning that it's a lie from the pit of hell. It is God who gives life, and it is God who planned your birth. You were on God's calendar. You were on God's agenda. The Bible says that God watches over his word to perform it. Praise God. Now, 2 Corinthians chapter number 3. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. Amen. Verse number 2. You are our epistle, written in our hearts, known and read by all men. Clearly, you are an epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but by the Spirit of the living God, not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of flesh, that is, on the heart. What Paul is saying here is that you are a letter. You are a letter. An epistle is a letter. He's saying you are our letter, written in our hearts, known and read by all men. Clearly, you are a letter of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but by the Spirit of the living God, not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of flesh, that is, of the heart. Praise God. You are a love letter from God to the nation. You are a love letter from God to the world. It is through you and I, friends, that people come to know God. When people look at, you see, God is the writer of the letter. He is the author of your life. And every promise that God has made in your life is in this wonderful book called the Bible. You got to spend time with the Bible so that you can grow and you can understand who you are. And you can understand what is available to you in Christ Jesus. It is through the gospel, it is through the Word of God that we see Jesus, that we're able to grow in our relationship with Christ. That we can see ourselves no longer as being ourselves, but we see ourselves as being Christ's, as belonging to Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, you are a love letter from God to the world. That is powerful. That is powerful. Every promise that God has is in this word. And as you take those promises and you make them your own, you got to lay a claim on them. Grab a hold of them. If you ever wanted to know the will of God, You've got to go to the Word of God. This is God's will for your life. That is, to put it another way, this is the will and testament of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Through his death, he's given us the testament, the testimony. Now we know what is available to us. He's left us an estate. And it's up to you and I to manage that estate. You know, if somebody were to receive an inheritance and they received a wealthy estate, it would really be something foolish for you to have with you the will and testament in your hand, which declares and tells you and outlines exactly what's available to you, but you don't go claim it. This is the will and testament of God to you. So that whatever happens in your life, line it up with the Word of God, line upon line, precept upon precept. If it doesn't match up with the Word of God, if it doesn't come in line with the Word of God, it's not for you. Hallelujah. It's through the Word of God you find out what's available to you. And you are a word from God. That means every promise that God has in this word that you download into your spirit, it will come to pass. The Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, you always read, the Bible says, the Lord said, and then you read, and it came to pass. The Lord said, and it came to pass. And I'm here to tell you this morning, what God said to you probably in 1987, it's coming to pass. What God said to you in the year 2000, it's coming to pass. What God said to you in 2005, it's coming to pass. What God said to you in 2010, it's coming to pass. And what God has told you now in 2020, it's coming to pass. You can depend upon God. You can rely upon God for him to bring his word to pass in your life. The Word of God, the Bible says, the Word of God, it will never fail. The Word of God will always remain. Praise God. This is a word of love, God's love. And you are a word from God. Amen. Now, I want to read something to you from 1 John. And it's so important how you see yourself. How do you define yourself? John the Baptist was asked by the Jewish leaders, the priests and the Levites. They came to him and they asked him, who are you? So my question to you this morning is, who are you? It's probably the world out there is asking this morning, who are you? Let's read about John. What was John's answer? Verse 19 of John's Gospel, chapter 1. Now this is the testimony of John. You see, this is the testimony of John. When the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, who are you? He confessed and did not deny, but confessed, I am not the Christ. And they asked him, what then? Are you Elijah? He said, I am not. Are you the prophet? And he answered, no. Then they said to him, who are you? Second time. That we may give an answer to those who sent us. What do you say about yourself? And John the Baptist replies, he says, I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord. My friend, this morning, my word to you is that you are the voice of one crying in the wilderness. The world that we see, the world is a wilderness of want. The world is always in want. If you speak to anybody, the world is in want. There is want for everything in the world. And you and I, we are the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Make straight the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Hallelujah. That's you and I. That is who we are. You are telling people, get ready for what God is about to do. Hallelujah. This one thing that we are looking for and we are so excited to see as the body of Christ, it is the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And yes, he is coming again. Praise God. Hallelujah. And whilst we are in waiting, friends, we are not in want. You can tell the world out there, I am not in want of anything because the Lord Jesus, he is my shepherd. I shall not want. Hallelujah. Because of Jesus, he is my shepherd. I shall not want. I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Whatever situation you may be facing this morning, whatever your circumstance is this morning, go to the word of God. Friend, you are a word from God for your generation. You are a word from God for your nation. So you go into the word of God and you speak this word. Speak it into the atmosphere. Speak it out. Vocalize the word. Hallelujah. Give voice to the scriptures in your life. Give voice to the scriptures in your circumstances. And you are saying, make straight the way of the Lord. God is about to make the crooked way straight. God is about to heal the sick. God is about to do something that's going to shake this whole earth. Hallelujah. Praise God. That is our message. You are a word from God. Amen. That's the first thing I told you, is that you are a word from God. The second point is that you are a letter of God. God is writing your life story. And as people are looking at your life, they are reading your life. They are seeing what God is doing in your life. Praise God. God is not done with your story yet, friend. It's not yet over until God says that it's over. If God hasn't said it, then you don't believe it. You don't put up with it. You go according to what the Lord has said. Thus saith the Lord. I love that. The Bible doesn't say, thus said the Lord. Thus saith. Thus saith means what he said yesterday, he's saying it today, he's saying it tomorrow, he'll be saying it forevermore, because he does not change. Our God doesn't change, his word doesn't change, praise God. So whatever your circumstance is, you can say, thus saith the Lord God Most High, amen. And it is through your life, friends, the most powerful sermon ever preached, the most powerful sermon ever preached for your life. It is not nice, fancy words. It is not jumping and shouting. And that is not the most powerful sermon that will get people saved. The most powerful sermon that will get people saved and bring people to the Lord and will release the power of God in your life through you is the sermon of your life. Let your life be that sermon. Let your life preach about the goodness of God. Let people see the love of God through your life. That when they see you, they'll say, my goodness, this person was barely making ends meet. But look at them now. Look what the Lord has done. Praise God. This person was in a wheelchair. This person was riddled, couldn't walk, couldn't do anything. But look what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. And you can take this very same word and you can go to the nations out there, go to the people out there and share the message of the gospel with everybody. You are a seed from God. You are a word from God with the purpose of you bearing fruit for the kingdom of God. So I want to encourage you this morning, friend, to really take every opportunity to share what God has done in your life. It is through your testimony that others come to know the Lord. So don't be stingy with your testimonies. Don't be stingy with what the Lord is doing in your life. You cannot afford to be silent. You cannot afford to be stingy and mingy. God is not a stingy God. He wants to give more. He wants to give you more testimonies. So keep on sharing your testimonies with others about what good the Lord has done for you. Amen. I'm reminded of a scripture where Jesus healed a man and he told him, go and tell your friends, go and tell your neighbors what good the Lord has done for you. And that is purely, you are a word from God. And it doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter what people have said about you. It doesn't matter what label people have tagged you with or what they've branded you with. You are a brand made by God. The Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. All things have become new. You are brand new. Praise God. And you don't need to answer, friend, whatever you are going through. You don't need to answer for yourself. You don't need to speak for yourself. You have a God who speaks for you. If you look in the Bible, you see God is always speaking. And that's my word to you this morning, is that God will speak for you and God will speak through you. God hasn't changed. God, you know, when you look at the life of Abraham, you see what God did. Abraham was a word from God. And even now, when we read the life of Abraham, that is a word to us too. We receive from his life. He is a word. When we read the life of Joseph, we receive from his life. That is, he was a word. Amen. The life of Joseph and Moses and Ruth and Esther. The Bible is full of accounts of men and women who serve God, who were a word from God. Praise God. And you are a word from God. And people are reading your life. And let it be said of you too, just like the patriarchs of old. Surely, Emmanuel, God is with us. God is with us. God is with you. Laban recognized that God was with him because of Jacob. People will realize that God is with them through you because you are a word from God. That wherever you are planted, wherever God has planted you, don't run away. Don't run away because situations or circumstances have become uncomfortable. Stay there and grow. You will grow. The word of God will cause you to excel. The word of God will cause you to grow. You will grow. You will. This is a word of excellence. Hallelujah. And this word truly will cause you to excel in life. No matter what you're going through, the word of God will cause you to grow. And you are a word from God, a voice for your generation. Hallelujah. So dare this morning to be different. Amen. Praise God. Now, if you haven't received the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I want to offer you the opportunity this morning to receive the Lord Jesus and to have a relationship with Him. And, you know, you can just say the simple prayer with me and receive the Lord Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. Amen. Now let us pray together. Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, your Son, according to your word. If I shall confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with all of my heart that God raised him from the dead, I shall be saved. Right now, Lord Jesus, I open the door of my heart to you and I ask you to enter my life. Come into my heart. I receive you as my personal Lord and Savior. I confess that you are Lord. I thank you for the gift of eternal life that you have imparted to me right now. In your precious name I pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Praise God. Well, congratulations. Welcome to the family of God. I want to encourage you, if you've said that prayer, connect with a church in your local area and begin to grow in your newfound faith in Christ Jesus. Write to us. The details are appearing on the screen and share with us what good the Lord has done for you. Until next time, this is Pastor Ricardo saying God bless you. Have a wonderful week. And before I let you go, let us just release a word of blessing. So stretch your hands towards the screen as a contact point. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for your precious people. I pray that in blessing, you will bless them. In multiplying, that you'll multiply them. I pray that they will grow, that they'll increase, O Lord God. Yes, Father, with the understanding and the knowledge of your Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Almighty God, I thank you right now in your precious name. And now, child of God, the Lord bless you, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you, both now and forevermore, in Jesus' blessed name. Amen, amen, amen. Praise God. Till next time, goodbye, and God bless you.